Hey, Paris, have you guys seen the movie Step Brothers?
Yeah.
You know when they interview as a team?
Huh?
You know in the scene where they interview as a team? Is that what you guys are doing?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Did you not see the Big Ten Network?
No, I don't watch the Big Ten Network.
they literally did a Step Brothers skit.
Oh, I have no idea.
We just I know you watched Twitter. He'd be on Twitter
all day.
We just talked to Damon Arnett, and he said that receivers get away with more than corners every single snap. How would you respond to that?
He said they're illegal on every play. Yeah. They break the rules on every play.
Do they cheat on every play? He said yes.
Oh, excuses to me.
Us or them?
Said no, receivers in general. All of you.
DBs for the whole day.
So, do corners get away with more than receivers?
They make more excuses than receivers.
For sure.
Mm-hmm. I don't worry about that. You worry about that?
Guys, teams now have film on Dwayne Haskins, which they didn't have at the beginning of the year. I know that each week you face a different defense, but are you finding that teams are trying to take away the deep ball more so than maybe when there was no film on Dwayne Haskins out there?
Well, I mean, you play outside receiver, so you would know more than me.
I don't feel like they always try to take away our deep ball since, like, you know, Devin Smith or whatever. You know, so, of course, like, with a guy like Dwayne, who can really just throw the ball all over the place, you probably put more on it, trying to take away the big shot. So, probably, you know, coming down the line is going to just see more preventive defense of the deep ball.
Johnny, though, when you break wide open the other day on that, I call it a seam corner route, whatever, for your touchdown and stuff, and the ball's right there. I mean, was that a near perfectly executed pass play against a defense that gave it to you?
Yeah, I think it was a perfectly executed play. It was something we've been working on. It was nice to finally get it out and put it on the field.
Yeah, but you called, you know, a few weeks ago when I asked you about what does a pass look like coming from Dwayne, you said it looks like mom's home cooking.
Yeah.
And what did that one look like?
Same thing.
You have an analogy you use, guys?
No, I just double back on that. I like that one. I never said that.
We still my stuff.
I'm not, but I like that
one. Chris, you're a big reason for this, actually, so I'm going to ask you. You're so good at picking up yards and bunches. Are you guys as comfortable on 3rd and 7 as you are 3rd and 1 as an offense?
Most definitely. This season, the receivers, I feel like we're super confident in ourselves. You know, it's when we're in a situation like 3rd and 7, 3rd and long, you know, we feel like we need to be counting on them to make those plays and get those conversions. But I just think that that's through the work that we put in the offseason. And then obviously, you know, building each week, but we're overly confident in those situations for sure.
You guys all came back, and obviously Ben and Austin were coming back. What has been the biggest difference in terms of production? Obviously a different quarterback and whatnot, but in terms of you guys, why has there been such a jump statistically in what you guys have been able to do this year?
Well, you talking personal or as a group?
Yeah, as a group. Just it was the same guys last year. You know, I know there's a year more experience and a different quarterback, but why has there been such a jump, I guess, halfway through the season?
Honestly, I think just because, as receivers, I think each and every one of us has developed. We've become more polished receivers. Not that, you know, the guys weren't before, but I just think that we've added, you know, more little tweaks and techniques to our game. You know, we think about the game completely different now than we did a year ago. I just feel like when we go into a game now, I think it's completely different than it was in the past.
And not to take away from JT or anything he did, but Dwayne obviously is a throw-first guy. I mean, does that make it that you guys are, you know, the ball's probably coming to you, you know there's the deep shots and things like that that maybe weren't as big in the offense a year ago?
Yeah, definitely. You definitely got to be always ready. You know, to you know, just add on to that, I mean, I think a lot of guys got a lot of personal goals as well. So, you know, each and every route, we're critiquing ourselves and, you know, we're putting stuff on film. Even if we know, you know, the ball maybe is not coming our way, we want to run good routes just because, you know, we know scouts and things, you know, they watch that stuff. So, but with a guy like Dwayne, you always got to be ready no matter, you know what the read is, what the certain play is. You always got to be ready because you never know. So.
And Victor, Coach Meyer said 2-3 weeks ago, whatever it was,
that he became one of you, that whatever it was, the light went on, or what was it with him? Was there a moment? Was there something that happened that things clicked for him?
I think the moment that really helped him, like, probably transition was a play in TCU. He had to go in there and crack a backer, and he put it on film. He went in there and he laid his body out to try to make that play. So I think that was a boost in the right direction for him, you know, and then he just saw him keep going throughout the weeks, you know, keep building himself. And there's a lot of plays he made this summer a lot of us couldn't make, like the one against Penn State. That catch was insane, and the run out there, it was like one of the catches we talked about, like, no disrespect to anybody in our group, but we didn't think anybody else but Ben could have made that play. So he's just coming along. I mean, he's coming along strong. Also with the catch he just made Saturday, that was insane. So he's just, I think when they say he's coming along and becoming one of us, it's just he's growing up and, you know, he's making those plays that he probably didn't make last year.
How much do you guys have to prod him and get him to mature, if that's the right word?
It's not on us. It was mostly on him, you know. Just finding something within himself and pushing himself to another level this year.
How deep have y'all gotten into the playbook, the passing playbook? Have we seen it all? I mean, what is there a lot more to come? What's your sense of that, Paris or Johnny?
No, I don't think you guys have seen it all. We have 100% trust in our coordinators and offensive coaches. But I definitely think, just from flow of the game, you know, what's at stake. What situations we're in, you know, they make the calls based on that. But I think we have a lot of stuff, a lot of shot plays that maybe we can't get to just because of certain looks the defense is giving us, things of that nature. But we definitely have a lot more in store for sure.
Is Terry truly taking out defensive ends like he's some sort of tiny offensive lineman?
Yeah, definitely. Terry's a guy that, you know, he's not a one man pony. You know, he can do it all, whether that's blocking or running routes, catching. He's just a smart player. And he's just a guy that, you know, he's kind of irreplaceable.
He said he didn't
two more
think
questions,
that
folks.
Ended up on film. Did it end up on film?
Everything ends up on film.
Everything. Yeah.
So Terry, how many times did you watch him
Terry,
take it? Yeah.
Every game.
Yeah. Every game, Terry has a big block. Like, you know, might not come up in a stat sheet, but, you know, stuff like that is recognized around this building. And, you know, we take that stuff very seriously.
How much are you guys inspired by Michael Thomas and what he's done? I mean, or are you at all?
I say a little bit, but my inspiration comes from things bigger than just a person, you know, mostly my family, my daughter who's on the way, you know, so I guess he inspired a lot of people because he came from here and he's doing it at a high level right now, but inspiration goes deeper than that for me. I'm pretty sure he can say that as well, but I guess he's kind of something, he's like a idol kind of deal, like in our room, I guess. Mm-hmm. Austin loves him. Austin's probably his biggest fan. But Mike is just an inspirational guy. I mean, you saw him come from like the pits to being like one of the greatest of all time, like, in this program.
So. You see his Twitter beef last night?
Oh yeah, that's Mike. Yeah, that's I saw the Mike. Whole game. I was watching like it's gonna be a long one for him.
Josh Norman. Hey Johnny, with the new rule.
Thank you.
With the new rule on kickoffs and fair catches, has that changed your mentality at all when you're going back there?
Not mine, but the coaches. I want to return everything, but
it sucks.
Yeah, it sucks so bad. I want to return everything, but
I want to break one.
Right now, like sometimes it's just like, if you back up a little bit, just fair catch it. Last week I kind of backed up a little bit, but I still took it. 1 week CJ came to like stop me, from it. Like I didn't hear him, but yeah, it's that rule is crazy. I mean, it's kind of helpful, I guess, at times.
What is the guideline? What do the coaches tell you?
When you only three, but if you have to back up at all, fair catch or sit it down.
Johnny, when's your daughter due?
January 15th.
Okay, so you're not worried about missing a game or anything like that. You're not going to pull up Carlos Hyde.
No, hopefully not. Hopefully she doesn't come around national championship time or whatever we're doing at the end of the season.
Gentlemen, thank you very much.
Yes, sir.